Of course, you could chain different logical and comparison operators, for instance such expression as 5 and string ABC and not number 3 is fully valid Python expression. Let's see result, and result is false. But please be careful when you combine and OR operators. For instance, if here will be OR operator like that, I'll get 5. But if I put this part of this expression into parentheses, like that, here open paren and here is closing paren, I'll get different result, I'll get false. Because now with those parentheses in place, this expression must be truthy, and this must be truthy. But if I remove parentheses and get to previous variant like that, this value will be returned back as a result of this expression, because Python processes operands one by one. And here we find first truthy value, before OR operator, and that's why it is returned back as a result of this expression. That's why if you want to mix OR and AND operators, please use parentheses in order to modify order how Python interprets such expressions. Alright, that's it for logical operators in Python. Conditional and logical operators are most often utilized in if-conditional statements. And now let's talk about them. Syntax consists of such keywords as if, elif, and else. Let's start just with if keyword. Let's define new variable and let's call it name, and let's assign value to it, for instance Bogdan. And here will be condition if name, let's perform some action, let's print name to the terminal, like that. Let's save changes, run code, and I see Bogdan here in this output, because now this condition is truthy. This means that in if conditional statement, this block of code is executed only if such condition is truthy. You could add here multiple statements same as you do in function. For instance, you could print name twice, like that. It is fully valid block of code inside of the if statement. But if this condition is falsy, for instance if name is empty string like that, then this block of code will not be executed. And if you want to execute other block of code in case this condition is falsy, then you could use else statement like that. And here let's print to the terminal string name is empty like that. Let's run the code and I get name is empty in the output. Also, it's possible to add elif part to this if conditional statement. Let's get back to name Bogdan, and also let's add surname. I'll put my surname here, like that. And now let's do following. If name, let's print name. Next, after this if statement, let's add else if statement, shortly elif. Here will be one more condition, elif surname. Let's print surname. And here in this else block, instead of name is empty, let's write the name and surname are empty, like that. Let's run the code, and now I get Bogdan, because Bogdan is not empty. If it will be empty or for example none, I should get my surname, and yes, here it is. If surname is also falsy, for instance empty string, I'll get name and surname are empty. But what if I want to add one more condition and print both my name and surname in case both of them are present? Let's get back to real values here and let's think where we should add this new condition. For instance, let's try to add it here. Elif name and surname. Let's print name and surname like that. Let's now save changes and run the code, and I'll get Bogdan. Because if conditional statement stops here when this condition is evaluated to truthy, it does not proceed to other elif statements here, here, or to else here. That's why more specific condition, for instance this one in our example, we need to put above, before those less specific conditions, this one and this one. Let me cut it from here, like that, and put it here at the beginning of this conditional statement, and of course modify elif to if here and if to elif here, like that. Let's now save changes, run code, and now I get name and surname. And if name is false now, like that, I'll get only my surname here in this block. That's how conditional statements work in Python. Only one block will be executed, either this one, or this one, or this one, or this one, if all previous conditions were false, like, for example, now. And basically, under the hood, Python converts each expression to Boolean. It means that such condition and condition bool name and surname is equal to true are the same. But you don't need to perform such conversion yourself. Python does it for you under the hood. That's why you only need to enter specific expression in the condition part and don't care about its conversion to Boolean. Alright, that's it for if-else statements in Python.